We're here today at the Thame Valley Viaduct on the outskirts of Aylesbury. I'm stood at the halfway point of the viaduct. This is a unique viaduct for a number of reasons. The primary reason is the use of precast components, which has a number of benefits for the project. The viaduct is also unique as a very long and low-lying viaduct within the River Thame floodplain. Just under a year ago, we installed the first piers on this viaduct. In October, we installed the first beams, and now I'm really pleased to report that in the spring, we began the installation of the precast planks that form the deck. Cumulatively, that means that we're now over halfway on the construction of this viaduct. The Thame Valley Viaduct is particularly interesting from an engineering perspective because it makes extensive use of precast components. We have a factory in Kent where the piers and the precast planks that form the deck are constructed. So the precast elements are brought in overnight, ready to be installed on the viaduct on the next working day. So that means we make a particularly efficient use of our time. The teams can install the units extremely quickly and we can run a just-in-time approach, which minimises the amount of time and resource required on site. All of the piers on this viaduct are precast, other than the two behind me, which are cast in situ. These two piers mark the halfway point on the viaduct, and these are the fixed piers, and the viaduct expands north and south from this point.
What is special and unique about the Thame Valley Viaduct is that we implemented a design for manufacturing and assembly approach, and we are precasting off-site most of the big elements of the viaduct. That is the piers, the beams, the plank deck, and the parapets. We have recently commenced post-tensioning works. This is really a milestone for the team because the post-tensioning design is what makes this viaduct and this design special. It allows us to stitch the beams together in a very clean and simple way that reduces the amount of work at height, reduces the carbon footprint of the viaduct, and it minimizes the impact on the community, reducing the number of deliveries and reducing the delivery program. The inspiration for this solution comes from other countries in Europe where high-speed rail has been constructed and tested throughout the years. In particular, the design for this viaduct comes from other viaducts that were developed and constructed in Spain.
I'm really proud of the progress we've made here at the Thame Valley Viaduct. This is a first of a kind railway viaduct here in the UK. It's been so successful that I look forward to seeing the same solution used at Edgecott Viaduct in Northamptonshire.